8 minutes after 7 o'clock in Trinidad and Tobago. Good to have you still with us on Morning Edition, whether you're listening on radio or watching on television. Well, let's talk about cause and effect, not cause and effect, cause and effect. Which is a non-profit, cause-related media and marketing company that exists to create content in multiple formats and media, both online and offline, to sensitize, educate, and transform our understanding of disabilities. The company, which is to be launched at the Little Carib Theatre on Sunday, is led by Francis Escayg, who many of you will know being involved in the music industry for a number of years. He is the father of a child with special needs, and he joins us now. Good morning, Francis. Good to have you,
thank you.
On the program. I understand the thing on Sunday has been sold out already.
It's sold out.
So you have a lot of money to make from this organization then?
Well, it's just a start. Actually, it shows a lot of support from the people at Trinidad and Tobago, that they would think that what we are doing is important enough to attend and to support. So yeah, we think it's a good sign.
And just so we could give some information, cause and effect, if you want to find out more, and I'll repeat the contact information as well, 395-1990, 395-1990. The website is cause and effect, all one word, cause, and remember, it's not and, it's causeandeffect.co, and it's also on the Facebook page, cause and effect. Bottom line, Francis Escayg, what is this NGO all about? Because it's an environment that is becoming increasingly crowded with NGO after NGO. What is this one about?
This one is really about paving the way and casting the foundation for inclusion. All right, we think
that's a broad thing. What does it mean in real terms?
It means that we believe that in order for anything to gain traction, any type of social program to gain traction, there must be awareness and education going forward.
And this has been inspired by your own circumstances with one of your children. You may be uncomfortable going into too much detail, but just give us a sense of the circumstances that would have prompted your decision to form this organization.
When I asked myself what would happen to Isaiah, who is now 8, when I asked myself what would happen to him when I die, that was a very troubling question, because when he was born, but you know, we had a lot of problems finding solutions, finding, you know, support.
And what is his condition?
Incontinentia pigmenti. He's been diagnosed with incontinentia pigmenti.
And in layman's language, what does that involve?
It's a gene mutation. He was supposed to die in utero. Males don't usually make it. They were able to diagnose him based on some marks he had on his skin, his crossed eyes, pegged teeth, and his delayed development.
And how old is he now?
He's 8.
He's 8 years old now. And from birth till now, what has the experience been like for your family in coping with the challenges faced by Isaiah?
It's difficult. I don't think it's unique. We are unique in any regard. I think it's difficult for everybody having a child with special needs. It doesn't only place a lot of strain on the personal relationship with your spouse, with the siblings. There's the financial strain. There's the lack of resources. There's the wondering what school he will go to, what will happen to him when he turns a teenager, all these different things, you know. And looking at it, having a child with special needs really makes you see how deficient our system is in terms of not even just providing for children with special needs, but the humanity aspect of the way we live is not very accommodating for anything that's different or that we think is outside of what we believe is supposed to be normal. So we are faced with a number of challenges, and I basically had to stop everything I was doing, slow right down to communicate with him, to feel him, to understand what it could be like, what he could be going through as well. It's not only what I was going through. And that was a big revelation for me. And that also caused a turning point. I went back to school. I did my master's in creative design entrepreneurship to get my skills and tools to see how I could create communities, sustainable living communities where persons with special needs can live, work, earn an income, and contribute in a positive way to our society. Those societies exist, those communities exist in the world today, but part of my research is about how do I make it work in Trinidad and Tobago, right?
How difficult is it to make that work in TNT right now?
Well, my research pointed basically to the fact that if we were to just go out there and start to build these communities, they most probably wouldn't gain traction because the people of the Republic don't understand what that is all about. And that was the birth of cause and effect.
That's what I was going to ask you. Why go the way of an NGO? And that's why I made the comment earlier on about an increasingly cluttered environment as far as NGOs, that everybody want to get a piece of the government money.
Right.
And so some will say, essentially, what Francis Escayg is here about, and because of his sphere of influence in the entertainment industry, he has all the connections already, so now he's just plugging into more of the government money.
Well, actually, I'm not going after the government money. The whole concept behind cause and effect is that we are here to help other NGOs, because, again, our research has pointed me to the fact that we think NGOs in Trinidad and Tobago can do a lot more. I've done a lot of research between NGOs and corporations. I mean, you know, I did man on the street surveys and all of these type of things. NGOs can be more dynamic in our environment to cause and to create change. I think that, you know, I believe the reason why it isn't like that is for a number of reasons. One being that, you know, all NGOs, when they start, they may have a really good idea, and then they bring all these different influential people from corporate Trinidad and Tobago on their board, depending on these people to lead and guide. And these people now bring another corporate mentality to what is supposed to be a dynamic organization who can affect change, take risks, you know. So we get back into the conservative kind of operation where, okay, you need to, if I give you $50,000, you have to sit down and make sure all your books, that is fine, you have to do those things. But the thought leader, the person who has to be dynamic and go out there and say, okay, how do we forge new relationships? How do we do this in a different way without depending on money from the government, without depending on money from any one of our other organizations?
This could almost be a political discussion that we were having previously, because okay. Essentially, the point is, if I understand you correctly, is that people who do things with a particular principle, a particular idea in mind, invariably is either diluted because of the realities
that
you have to get the money from the government,
right,
or some corporate entity that will come with their own philosophy and take over the show.
Exactly.
And I mean, what is going to prevent cause and effect from going down the same road?
We are prepared to do it in a different way right now. We have, in the first quarter of 2013, which is when we just started to roll out how we want to deal with 2013, we reached out to a few NGOs, Families in Action. You know, they're now celebrating their 25th anniversary. We didn't know. We went to them and said, how can we help you? We did a jingle for them. We started offering other expertise and advice. And we will be working with them this year to help them make the most of 25 years. We worked with another NGO, Horses Helping Humans. We did a little short film for them to help them be able to better position themselves in the market. So we bring in those skill sets to NGOs.
Are people suspicious of your motives? That what would Francis Escayg doing? Is he here just to shove me away to suddenly come with his own group and take over the show?
I won't doubt it. I can get that type of feeling sometimes when you're talking. I mean, people will feel threatened by another NGO coming on the scene, but I'm here to not take anything but just to give and to add value to all the work that we are doing as NGOs. I believe that we can do more, and my mission is basically, we are launching our fundraiser on the 19th. We have a big run coming up in September called the September Project, and we are going to be launching and raising funds between now and that time and the end of the year. But this is through the people of the Republic. We're not going to be going to government and say, you know, we're doing this and we need this money and stuff like that. No, we believe that we have the prize, and I think that NGOs need to believe that they have the prize, because the prize becomes money when you go to someone to say, boss, we need some money to do this, and the person will tell you what they want you to do with the money.
Yeah.
You deviate from your dream and from your vision and from your goal, and then you end up just being another cog in the wheel, just like what we just spoke about.
But is this not in itself a deviation from your desire to provide for a better life for Isaiah, even when you are gone? The reason I ask that, why not just form a support group? And get all the people activated into dealing specifically with that child. Why go the way of an NGO and broadening your horizons to other things and other challenges?
Because we believe that we have a deficiency in our society where empathy doesn't exist. We believe that a lot of people don't even know what the word means, a greater understanding. Some will say that we are very selfish people. I believe that, and we have seen it, we did a short film, 4.5 minutes, and when we put that out there, people weep, they bawl, they cry, they say, we understand what it is, we now know what this is about. And that has proven, just that one short film has proven to us, we were able to measure it and say, okay, you know something, people want to hear real stories, people want to be able to connect. There are a lot of really good people in Trinidad and Tobago, But unfortunately, it's just the bad things that get projected a lot of times. We are saying, you know what? Leonardo da Vinci said there are three kinds of people in this world. There are those who get it. There are those who get it when you explain it to them. And there are those who just don't get it. And I believe that we have a lot of the first two categories in Trinidad and Tobago. I mean, the next third, I think they're in the minority, because the majority of people, everybody has a heart. And we reach out and we want to help people, and even though we may live selfish lives. So I believe that there are a lot of really good people in Trinidad and Tobago. And cause and effect is saying, you know what? We are going to reach out to the people of the Republic, and we are going to measure it by the end of this year if our concept was successful, simply because we're saying we are going to go this route. If we fail at that point in time and we don't achieve what we set out to do, we're going to just have to re-engineer the whole structure.
Just to remind everybody about the contact information for the organization, it's Cause and Effect. It's a non-profit cause related media and marketing company. It's a new NGO. 395-1990. causeandeffect.co is the website, and it's also on Facebook. So following the event, the formal launching on Sunday, what happens after that?
Okay, we'll be making an announcement about our major fundraiser, which is this run, a relay marathon. Mm. We have six ladies called Poison Ivy. Mm. They are mix of moms and corporate ladies who have decided that they want to help Cause and Effect with this project. And they are running from Point Lisas to Port of Spain in a relay. Mm. Each of them will be taking on a leg of, you know, taking on a number of people on their leg of running a 5K. And we are going to be generating a lot of interest and awareness about the need for proper content. And I want to stress this, because a lot of people talk about creating awareness, but we are also concerned about the signal to noise ratio. And I'm not saying this in any condescending manner, because we have done the research. It is important when you're creating content that there is an objective. What is the objective? How do you create an inclusive society? You must build empathy and create a greater understanding. You just don't put somebody in a wheelchair, and I'm going to say it like, you just don't put somebody in a wheelchair to say, hi, my name is so-and-so, and I am differently able, but I am still able, and all this kind of stuff. You don't do stuff like that, because a lot of times, if you keep hitting on a wall with that type of activity, people start to turn off, because it's not adding value.
Because people actually say, look, you know, I mean, I fed up all of this,
exactly.
You know, because they don't register with me anymore.
Exactly.
Because you get it all the time. It's always, you put some unfortunate person in front to make people feel sorry, and they say, look, we had enough of this.
Exactly, right? So people turn off of that. So that is why Cause and Effect sees creating awareness campaigns as very important in building that empathy and creating that understanding. That, and you know something? That will have a ripple effect into every area of society. It's not just about disabilities. We're dealing with disabilities, but this will help in so many other ways to build our humanity.
Final word, Francis Escayg. Do you really believe that we are a caring society? Because the feeling is that because we feel more comfortable in our own environment, whether it's liming and how party, you know, or whatever else it is, that we are essentially a selfish, callous society.
The way I will answer that question is this. You know, I know that, let's just even say in governments, I know that there are many good people that are called to service. I have known some of these people in both parties prior to going into government, right? Really good people who really want to do well for the country. But the government is a different beast. I would say that our society is a different beast. But inside of there are really good people. And generally, we say that we may be selfish and callous and, you know, cold-hearted and stuff like that. I think a lot of people just don't know how they can help sometimes, or they maybe need a little help in understanding that, hey, stop. You can help too. All you need to do is this, you know. I don't think it is as impossible as sometimes as we feel, and overwhelming as we feel it is.
Francis, it's good to get your perspective.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
For coming in. And again, the organization Cause and Effect, the launch is on Sunday, sold out, and indeed they'll be rolling out some more messages in trying to fulfill their objectives, personal and general, in many senses. We'll be back right after this.